Lonnie West with LEZ Preamps, and today I want to talk about battery drain. Your battery should last at least 6 months, usually 6 to 8 months. So I thought today would be a good chance to kind of go through how is power used and switched inside of the preamp circuit. That way you can better understand what to look for when you're trying to diagnose your own battery problems. So let's take a look at a block view of the schematic. So this is kind of what I consider a cartoon drawing showing how power flows inside of the LHZ preamp. I'll explain what we're looking at first. So your battery goes into the preamp. Internally, that negative lead passes straight through to the ring connector on your barrel jack. The barrel jack has three connectors, tip, which is your preamp out, ring, which is the ground coming in, and then the sleeve, which is the ground return. So the ground return coming from the barrel jack will come back into the preamp circuit. It'll power the actual innards of the preamp. It'll also go out via this ground connector for your input, which is where it'll connect to your pot ground, your chassis ground, and the ground on the pickups. Your cavity will also have a conductive coating or foil, and this is also connected directly to the sleeve. The end result is that this output jack acts like a switch. When nothing is plugged in there, this ground goes out to this terminal and doesn't go anywhere. So the preamp is unpowered and the pickup is unpowered. And I put little light bulbs on there to kind of give us a visual indicator of the power state. So when we plug in a standard quarter inch jack, and this is your guitar jack, so it's got a tip and a sleeve, that ground connection, the long spring touches the sleeve, and it connects to the sleeve connector, so that allows the ground to return. So now we have power on the preamp, we have power on the pickup. So this is your normal operating mode. So where we can get battery drain are from a couple different scenarios. One is if the battery negative is directly connected to the cavity or a ground or a pot. In this case, instead of going through the switch with nothing plugged in there, this battery negative is connected to the cavity, which is then connected to the pot, which is then connected to the pickup. It's also connected back to the preamp. Therefore, even being unplugged, the preamp is on and the pickup is on. So it's constantly using your battery the entire time. So the first thing you're going to want to look for is if you're having high battery drain is to make sure that the battery is directly connected to the preamp. It doesn't splice off here and go in two other directions. It should just be one black wire from the battery into the preamp. A great way to test this, if you're not sure if you have a ground issue or not, is to simply take a voltmeter and measure voltage between the battery positive and the sleeve of your barrel jack or your output jack. You could also measure it between that positive connector and a volume pot if you have traditional volume pots. With the base unplugged and a battery in there, if you're measuring voltage between the positive battery terminal and the sleeve, then you have something connected to the ground. And it's either going to be a ground wire directly from the battery, or it's going to be reversed RS ring and sleeve connectors. Another common scenario is getting the sleeve and ring connections reversed. This one doesn't make immediate sense until you start thinking about power flow. So again, in this case, following the negative lead from the battery, comes down, goes out what's thinking the ring connector, but it's connected to the sleeve. At that point, that sleeve connection is connected to the cavity shield, which connects it to the pot, which connects it to the pickup, also connects it back to the preamp. So we're basically bypassing this whole switching action, so that powers this whole circuit on. So your preamp is on and your pickup is now on. Another situation that happens quite often is when you plug in a TRS jack into the base. Instead of a normal guitar cord, which only has two conductors, a sleeve and a tip, you'll notice there are two insulators here giving you a tip, a sleeve, and a ring. When this is plugged in, you're not going to always get the expected result. And this is often occurs when you have some of the newer wireless units that have this type of plug on them. This plug is used for charging the wireless unit when it's plugged into the dock. But when you plug it into your base with an active preamp expecting the ring and the sleeve to act like a switch, you're actually passing your ground power back through the transmitter and back out. Most of the new transmitters expect this scenario on active instruments. However, not all of them respond very well. So a lot of times you'll either end up with the instrument not working correctly, or you'll end up getting a very high-pitched whine or other noise that's actually caused by this circuit not being fully completed and actually picking up noise from inside the transmitter. In those cases, if you do want to use one of those transmitters that's got a TRS connector on there, you're going to need to use a TRS to a regular tip sleeve connector on there. So that way, what you're actually plugging into the jack looks like this, just like a regular guitar cord, and that noise will go away and everything will work normally. So to sum up, two things to check when you got a battery usage: make sure that negative wire is only going to the preamp and it doesn't split off and connect to anything else except for the power jack on the preamp. And the second thing you want to check is your TRS connections from the LHZ preamp output to the barrel jack. The tip should be the tip. The sleeve black lead should be to the sleeve, and the blue wire should be connected to the ring. Hope that helps you, and have a great day.